Hello there. In this video, we are going to focus on what the difference is between a working file in Embrilliance Essentials and a stitch file. So a working file is a file with an extension .b at the end of it. And a stitch file is an embroidery file that an embroidery machine can read. They come in all different formats. So if you're on a Brother machine, it would be .pes. If you're on a Bernina, it might be .art or .exp, but those are stitch files. So why would you want to create a working file? Well, let's just say, for example, that you like a particular monogram. So for example, for my daughter's high school graduation, I was stitching out a lot of corduroy tote bags in her friend's school colors for the college that they had chosen. I was using actually a font that I created, which is called College Girl Monogram. And I did this with three separate letters. So let's just say we will use A, and we'll put that in, and then I will duplicate that. I'm going to copy my letter and paste it and move it over to the side. And then I am going to create another letter, and you're probably wondering why I'm doing this as three different letters. Well, I want these to be dramatically different sizes, so that's just my personal preference. So let's just say the monogram was this. All right, so we have a nice little monogram here. Now, if I love this, I can just simply say file, save a stitch file, and I'll save that stitch file as a .pes file so that I can stitch it out of my embroidery machine. But if you're going to be doing a lot of these tote bags and you want the monograms to be consistently sized, then what you can do is you can do file, save as a working file. So we'll say save working file. I'm just going to put it on my desktop for now. Desktop, and we will call it College Girl Monogram Tote Bag. Okay, and if I look at that file, let's go to the desktop here. Here we go, we'll go to the desktop. So do you notice that it's a .be file? That means it's a working file. Okay, let's close this and let's go back to my desktop and open it again. Here's the beautiful thing. This is editable. So if my next recipient has a last name of S, for example, and maybe the left is going to be H and the right is, for example, Z. Who knows? Okay. Now I may want to scooch them around a little bit just because sometimes letters look a little bit better. Moved around a little bit. This particular font, I took great pains to make all of the letters kind of a similar width when they're the similar size so that you'd have a nice balanced monogram. Anyway, then I can do file, save working file. I'm sorry, we don't need to save the working file again because we already saved it once, but let's say this specific monogram I want to stitch out. I will say save stitch file. And I'm going to, let's save it as HSZ. Okay, so that's my monogram. Now, I'm going to close this, and I want to show you the difference when I open HSZ in Embrilliance Essentials. It's no longer editable, so I can't go change these letters. This is the file that the machine wants to read. If I want to go back into this file and change those letters, we don't want to work with that file. We want to work with our working file, that .be file. So that, my friends, is the difference between a working file and a stitch file in Embrilliance.